Start the recording if you're not done.
Okay. Started. So first we will discuss about the simulation of the flash separator, even though this is very small topic, but there are so many things inside this flash separator that we should know. In day-to-day work, basically we are using this flash separator unit operation available in the HiSeq just for checking how much vapor is generating and how much liquid is there in a given stream. So apart from all those things, means separation, how much vapors are available in the given feed stream and how much liquid is available in the given feed streams, apart from these two things, there are so many other things that we can analyze by using this unit operation. So this flash separator is, role of this unit operation is just to separate the vapor and liquid. If it is two phase, that is vapor and liquid, it will separate the vapor and liquid. And next we will see if there are more than two phase, like vapor, liquid, liquid, vapor phase, liquid phase, lighter liquid phase and heavier liquid phase, then we can use a three phase separator, which is also available in the HiSeq. So these two tools are being used in HiSeq for separation of vapor liquid and vapor liquid liquid. So we will discuss about the case for vapor and liquid separation. So apart from this, is just if you have any particular stream in which you know the temperature of that particular stream, pressure of that particular stream and the flow rate and the composition, then as you had defined the stream in the earlier cases, after defining this stream, you will be able to know how much vapor fraction is available in that stream and how much liquid is there. So based on the vapor fraction available, you can easily identify that if 1000 kg per hour flow is coming and its vapor fraction is 0.5, then by default you will say that 500 kg will be the vapor and 500 kg will be the liquid. This is very simple and anybody can do it by doing the manual calculation without using the flash separator. But if you want to know details about, once you have separated the given feed stream with given vapor fraction, based on that vapor fraction you have separated the vapor and liquid phase, then based on this separation you will be able to know what are the various other properties of that liquid separated liquid stream and what are the properties for the separated vapor stream. To know all those things, we need this unit operation for further analysis. So what we will do, we will first like earlier cases, first we will define the stream with the given condition, like 51% of ethane, 20% of propane, and this, and with the given condition. Given condition means what is the temperature and what is the pressure of the particular stream. Then we will enter into the simulation environment. Once we will enter the simulation environment, then we will discuss other things that are available. So let us go to this is not only the simulation of the one separator stream. This we will define a stream, then we will, as we know that if we will compress any stream, then there will be some formation of the liquid. So first we will define the gas stream, then we will use the compressor to compress it. Once we will compress it, then because of this compression, the temperature of that particular stream will rise, and again we will cool it by using a cooler. Then the ultimate stream which we will be getting, that we will separate in the separator. This will be the entire case. So let's go to the HiSeq. Yes.
This is the same flash separator, the same as the flash drum that is used before the atmospheric distillation column in refineries. The flash drum, we call it. It is the same.
See the it. The name of this particular drum may be different for different cases. Okay, but the main objective will be to separate it based on the vapor and liquid and vapor liquid separation. The only difference is means when you are having a case in the let's say you are having a distillation column, then in that case you will be separating the vapor. You will be after the condensation from the column overhead, that liquid you will be sending into a drum. There also you can use this drum, even though name over there is a reflux drum, but you can use this flash separator only. I repeat, based on the application, its name may be different at different location, but the objective which they are performing, that will be the same. Basically, they will be separating the vapor liquid or vapor liquid liquid. Depending upon the phases available in your stream, it will separate. Let's say you are having a stream, the case which we will be taking here, this is having a two phase, and based on the two phase available, it will separate the vapor and liquid. For example, you are having a case which is having a three phase, like vapor, liquid, liquid. In that case, you are supposed to take the three phase separator. Once you will take the three phase separator, it will separate the vapor, then lighter liquid and heavier liquid. But in case if you have used the flash separator, which I am going to discuss for the three phase, like vapor, liquid, liquid, then it will not give you the correct result. It will only give the two phase, one vapor phase and one liquid phase. The liquid phase which you will be getting, that will be the combined liquid phase. Even though your actual stream is having three phase, like vapor, liquid, liquid, but since you have used the flash separator only for two phase, in that case it will generate only two stream, one vapor and one liquid. This liquid stream will not distinguish about lighter liquid and heavier liquid. It will give the properties of the mixed streams. So based on the applications for which you are using this flash separator, we name it. Like sometimes we name it as a flash drum, sometimes only drum. Even if you are going to simulate a large loop of the gas system, and there is a compressor, and you are having a compressor suction knockout drum. For a knockout drum also, you will be using this only flash separator. So from simulation point of view, this flash drum will be used. Either you are simulating the column reflux drum, or simple vapor liquid separation for flash drum, or you are going to simulate the compressor suction knockout pot or suction drum. In that case also you will be using this. But the case which we are going to take is basically it is having the composition of the ethane, propane, isobutane and normal butane. We are having the ethane, then propane, isobutane, normal butane. We are having these four components for this particular case. Now we will select the thermodynamic package. As usual for the refinery, Heng Robinson package is very much suitable, very much compatible for using for handling these hydrocarbon streams. Now I have taken the component, selected the component and selected the thermodynamic package. Now then after that we can jump into the simulation environment. Now we have entered the simulation environment. Now before proceeding for the further taking streams and defining the simulation streams and proceeding for the simulation, let's check what are the units available, what are the units that is given in your case. In my case, the temperature is given in degree centigrade, pressure kg per centimeter square, and the flow rate is kg per hour. So let's check if the unit, if this stream is different. First, what we will do, we will change the unit of that particular things like temperature. Here also temperature is degree C, pressure is given as kg per centimeter square gauge, but we are having the pressure in absolute. So what we will do, we will change the unit of pressure. Even though you can change the unit from the stream itself, but that you have to do each and every time. So to avoid the repetition of that, what we will do, in the beginning itself, we will change the entire unit which is applicable for our case. Now my pressure has been kg per centimeter square. Now after that pressure is given in pressure is kg per centimeter square and delta P in kPa. Delta P in kPa, it is there. So okay, now we have the condition of this steam at temperature is 50 degree C, pressure is 1 kg per centimeter square absolute, and the flow rate is only 100 kg per hour, and the composition is given in mole percent. So even though if we will enter from here, then it will and click the enter, it will navigate to the next button, or we can click the edit and go to this page. Here we can enter. So my ethane is 50 mole percent. See here percent wise basis is not given. So what we will do, we will see that it's given in mole and percent. 15 mole percent, that means 0.15 mole fraction ethane. Then propane is 0.220 mole per percent, that is 0.2. Then isobutene 60 mole percent, that is 0.6, and 0.05 as the butane. Now it is 100%. Okay, now my stream has been defined. Now we have defined the stream. We have selected the thermodynamic package. Then we have entered into the simulation environment. Now next will be, we will take the compressor and compress this stream up to a pressure of 2.5 kg per centimeter square. I will share this PDF document. So if you want to do the practice, then you can use this document and practice yourself. What we were discussing about 15 mole percent of ethane, 20 mole percent of propane, then butane and isobutane and normal butane. this steam is to be compressed to 2.5 kg. So from 1 kg, kg to 2.5 kg. For that we will be using a compressor to raise the pressure from 1 kg to 2.5 kg. Then temperature of that steam will rise. Then what we will do, we will cool it to 0 degree C. And while using the cooler, as we know, there will be some delta P across the any exchanger, whether it is cooler or heater. So here it is given as that delta P is 0 kPa. So next we will be using a compressor. Pressure change here. As we know, we need one outlet stream and one energy stream. So inlet is outlet to energy is Q100. Now next input it requires is either you define the delta P inside the compressor as we did in earlier cases, delta P, or you define your desired outlet pressure. So in my case, my desired outlet pressure is 2.5 kg. 2.5 kg. See, here temperature was 50 degrees C. After compressing it from 1 kg per centimeter square to 2.5 kg per centimeter square, temperature reached to 86.2 degrees C. And at 86.2 degrees C also, here we can see that compressor inlet and it is compressor outlet. Ideally, it should be both in gaseous phase or vapor phase, and it is there. It is in gaseous phase as vapor fraction is 1. So in our given problem, it is given that after this, what we will do is we will cool this stream to delta to 0 degree C with delta P of 0 kPa. So for that we will be using a cooler. And its inlet stream will be compressor outlet, and the cooler outlet stream will be 3, and its energy stream will be Q101. Now still it is not converse. What it is asking for unknown delta P. As we know that in our given problem, it is given that delta P across this cooler will be 0 kPa. Zero.
So.
Yes.
So how come the pressure drop is zero? There will be some pressure drop also, no?
Yes.
Pressure drop?
No, yes, definitely there should be some pressure drop. Mm-hmm. But mm-hmm. just for the practice purpose, this is given as zero. Even though, let's say, you take the 10 kPa.
Okay.
Ideally, there should be In practical sense, definitely there will be some delta P across the exchanger, maybe 10 kPa, 50 kPa, or 0.5 kg, 1 kg, whatever it is, but definitely there should be some pressure drop across the exchanger. Now, this is just for the practice purpose. Otherwise, when you are going to simulate the compressor, not only the inlet pressure and outlet pressure, in most of the cases, when you are doing some other exercise, then you will be having the compressor curve also. Then all those things you will have to input in the compressor. And for this case, we have taken the suction pressure of 1 kg and the discharge pressure of 2.5 kg. But even if you see that, for so many cases, that compressor outlet will be even much more than this. Based on the components we have chosen, and for the practice purpose we have taken this delta P zero. Doesn't matter, but the objective here is from compressor outlet that is 100% vapor to a certain temperature which we are going to fix, there should be some vapor and some liquid. This is our objective. Here it was 100% vapor, its temperature was 86.2 and pressure was 2.5 kg per centimeter square. Now after cooling into the compressor after cooler to 0 degree C, because of 10 kPa delta P, the pressure drop from 2.5 has reduced to 2.398 kg per centimeter square. Now the vapor fraction, initially it for steam number 2 it was 1, now it has become 0.7. So that means almost 70.35% is your vapor and the remaining is your liquid phase. So whatever feed is coming, like mass flow, that is your and one more thing, whenever this is your vapor phase fraction, that is 0.7035. this is very important. Here HYSIS will not mention anywhere your vapor phase fraction, either it is based on the mole fraction or mass fraction. It is not mentioned anywhere. Remember, this is based on the mole fraction only. This vapor fraction which is given here is based on the molar flow, that is it is the mole fraction. So 70% is your vapor, and the remaining 30% is your liquid. Now if you want,
you can do the man.
I think I have muted all the people. It's just
some. Only the water.
Okay. Now, after cooling into this cooler to 0 degree C, the vapor, and we can see there are 70%. 70% vapor and the remaining is liquid phase. Now what we will do, we will enter this steam as a feed to the flash separator that we were discussing in the beginning. So here it is given as the separator, all then dynamics and control, then external model, heat transfer manipulator, then piping and hydraulics, pressure changer, reactor, then separator. Now in the separator section, there is one thing, separator, then next is three phase separator, and next is tank. So tank, see the whatever calculation that your flash separator will be doing to estimate the properties of the vapor and liquid, that we will see over here. So this is your flash separator, this will be your vapor stream and this will be your liquid stream. Let's connect it and then analyze. My feed stream is 3, and let's say 4 is vapor and 5 is liquid. Now you have entered this cool feed into the flash drum. Now, as you can see, yes. Now, as you can see, whatever temperature is of stream number 3, this is same as stream number 4 and 5. Whatever is pressure is of stream 3, that is same as stream number 4 and 5. Now, next, whatever is flow, what flow is given here, 1.9957, it has split it into two parts, like vapor 1.376 and 0.5801 into the liquid. Since 70% is of my vapor, based on this 70% is vapor, so 70% of this is going to the vapor in stream number 4, and the remaining is going to the stream number 5 in the form of the liquid phase. See, now as I have asked that how the pressure delta P across the cooler can be zero. Yes, the delta P across the cooler will not be zero in practical sense. That's why we have taken 10 kPa. Likewise, if you are using this flash drum or flash separator, in this case also, those who are in the college, they may not be aware about the vessel sizing, but those who are working in any licensing or any EPC company, they will be knowing that once you are sizing this either two phase separator or three phase separator, whatever it is, the feed nozzle, which you are entering into this flash drum, there will be basically in this vessel, what we are doing, we are separating inside this drum vapor and liquid phase. So first separation is taking place at the vessel feed nozzle itself, feed nozzle. Then based on the vapor fraction available, it separates into the vapor and liquid. Liquid travels from the feed nozzle towards bottom, and vapor travels from the feed nozzle towards upward. So from the feed nozzle itself, as we know that the point at which feed is entering into this vessel, the point at which the feed is entering into the column, in simulation we are not showing any nozzle kind of thing, but actually when you will be seeing that, but when you will be seeing the actual, somebody is saying that why screen hung up, is it the same with others? I think there is some problem. Okay, let's again, only remaining time is 3 minutes, so let us once disconnect and connect once again. I think then it will be better. Some people's screen have and